Wow, this is great stuff. I'm totally excited. The other day I got an invite from some Christian umbrella group. I had no idea what it was all about. So I reached this place, and to my surprise, it was a Christian umbrella of human rights for gays, lesbians, gays, bisexuals, and the transgender and the queer. I was really surprised. I couldn't believe it. And these people, one is a pastor. He has a church in Karen. He just looked totally confused. And of course, the other one is also a pastor from the United States. And you can imagine all crap that they were trying to tell me. So, just from sight, and after I just found out what it was all about, I told them I don't agree with them and that I don't understand how it is that I got an invite from them to actually speak up on human rights issues. So I went ahead to interview this guy and just ask him, so what led him to think that that or to choose that gay lifestyle? He said he was born gay. I mean, you should have seen him throwing his hands up in the air like a woman. It just looked so wicked. He looked so crappiest. Oh my goodness, it was terrible. And then he brought out issues. I asked him, so what do you want from Kenya? Because we don't want this, and I don't, and I cannot support this, and I don't see what issue I am actually here to address and what it is that they really wanted from me. And so the guy said they want to push for policies here in Kenya to ensure that Kenyans are actually recognizing them. And that they're allowed to have their, the behind kind of thing without being condemned in any way. And I was like, oh crap, that place just literally for me, I think it was spiritual. To me, it just smelled like shit. I'm sorry, it just did. It was terrible, and I couldn't believe that this was what I was hearing. And it was so sad that there were pastor representatives from Kenya. And now it's very clear to me why that was happening. Again, I've always talked about the money factor, how it is just like Esau, selling his birthright, how Africans sadly have that thing in them that they can sell their souls for a bowl of soup, for a few dollars, for a few cents, and it's terrible. I'm just praying for the narrative to change. Because these people are selling their own people. So these pastors leave us because I argued and I was so pissed off and I was annoyed. And they called out the guy who was organizing and they said, wow, that lady's rude. She's arrogant. But I was glad it was arrogant. So I called even the guy who contacted me and I told him, how could you? How could he invite me for such a thing? And he knows my faith. He knows my affiliation. He knows what I stand for. And truth be told, it was something else. As a matter of fact, I had even asked the guy, so what does he believe about, human rights from the womb? And he said, a woman has a choice to do whatever she wants to do. So it's all a choice thing. And I told him, hey, you have a choice to do whatever you want to do, but you have a different autonomy in your womb or in a woman's womb when she's pregnant. This is somebody totally different who needs to be defended. And so it's like it's just something that's manufactured from the West because again they were from the States, but one of them is a Kenyan pastor here in Kenya, but of course they give him a lot of money. And so these pastors leave us once we, or they pass us once we were done. And of course I walked out and I was pissed off. And thankfully the journalists that were invited as well were like, "What the crap was that all about? What was that all about?" And all of them just felt like this is just crazy, and we were able to share, and all of us could see where this was coming from. And we kept on encouraging each other and saying, hey, we need to be the sober-minded ones. We need to ensure that our place in media is not used to confuse people, it's not used to brainwash people into this filth, and instead, we are there to liberate them with truth. Of who they are, really, what they have been designed to do, and their primary purpose here on Earth. So these guys are invading this land very fast under the Uhuru government. Sadly, they've had so much leeway. As you know, right now, marriage stops is still advertising, despite the fact that the Kenya Federation of the Kenya Films Commission Board banned their advertisements, but they're still doing this because there's somebody big there in government who's backing them up. Thankfully, there's a petition that is out, courtesy of Citizen Go and Kyoko. Kindly get to sign it. It's against them, and it's saying, Mary Stubbs has to be, first of all, stopped from operating and investigated over the allegations that have been made, which of course are not allegations. So I'm kindly asking you to search it out and sign. But I'm excited for Tanzania, Magufuli. I'm telling you, he's the man. I salute him, and I'm praying that Tanzania will embrace the truth that this man is actually releasing out there. He's the greatest president I have ever seen. If I could, I could. If I could, I would relocate and go to Tanzania. He's the coolest president that has ever existed, and I'm thankful. Wow, this is great stuff. I'm totally excited. The other day I got an invite from